All right, E3 happening in about 5 minutes. So yeah, gonna have some reactions here. I'm gonna make it full screen. There we go. Now, I'm just interested. Wow, that's not words. I'm just interested to know what they're gonna show. Obviously, like Star Wars Battlefront. I mean, it even says it right there on the screen. So, obviously that. I wonder if they're gonna be like EA Sports and stuff. Like, I wonder how all this is gonna go. Oh boy, there's. I think EA has its like Game Pass sort of thing too. So, I wonder if they're gonna advertise that anymore. I don't know. But we got like 5 minutes to go. I'm somewhat pumped for this. Like, E3 is the sort of thing where I just kind of hunker down, see what's up, chill. A lot less so than I used to, though, because when I was younger, I for sure was like, oh boy, I can't wait for E3. But, like, you know, like, I watch it now, but I'm not, like, overhyped for anything. I distinctly remember, though, in 2013, the Microsoft show, like, just all the E3 stuff was happening during, like, school. And me and, like, all my friends, we all just watched it in class. It was, like, probably really bad, but we just really, really wanted to watch it. And then they announced the Xbox One and all that. And we were like, oh boy, that's so cool. But then we all were like, what the heck is this? Because, you know, like they didn't even really show games. It was more of a, like, a entertainment show. They were like, oh, yeah, look, you could watch TV. Oh, hey, look. Blah, blah, blah. And then they're like, we got Steven Spielberg. And he's going to be making the Halo TV series. And we were like, yeah, that was really cool. But you know what? That hasn't come out yet. I think they forgot about it, or something went wrong with the deal. That's not a thing anymore, obviously. I know I'm not talking about EA, I'm just talking about E3 in general now. That's because, like, what else? And I distinctly remember, too, that, like, that was the E3 where they announced Ghosts, and they're all like, Riley, the dog, dog, dog. And it was, I'm interested to, like, I feel like the only thing that really keeps me watching E3 now is just all the debacles that happen. Like, there is a time, you know, everybody knows the classic Ridge Racer, and then, like, you know, like all that stuff, like the, oh yeah, this is a historical depiction of Japan, now here's the enemy giant crab. It's like, what? Or like, there's one where there's like 1 million soldiers, and he just kept saying that, and everyone was kind of giggling. He's like, it's not funny, it's extreme, and he whispered. Yeah, there's a whole bunch of like cringe and, I guess, hilarity to go on about these things. For instance, Miyamoto, when he was showing off Skyward Sword that one year, he kept missing the wall, like, missing the spiders hidden the wall. Like, we got 3 minutes to go. What's gonna happen? What are we gonna see? What are we gonna get? Like I said, obviously Battlefront, but oof. Now, it's just me, so I kind of have to play off myself, which is kind of weird. But, I mean, once the show starts, it should be pretty easy, because then I could just, like, kind of, you know, react to crap. The music they have playing, though, in the background is pretty neat, I suppose, for an EA press conference. Yeah, I just hope that they, like, announce cool stuff, and it's not really, like, terrible things. I wonder if they have, like, any, like, new IP. I'm sure they have a new IP, like, about to come out and about to announce it, but I'm just interested to know what, like, the other people are gonna have, like, the other companies are gonna have, like, under their sleeves, I suppose. It's a word to say that. Ugh. Do, bop, beep, bop, boop, bop, beep, beep, boop. Alright. It's getting closer, this is getting exciting. I mean, obviously, if you really wanted to, you could skip through to where I actually, like, start to react, but this is just, some free time where I could just talk, you know, let things go. Ugh. Look at these people all up on their phones, not even knowing what's to come. I wonder how that must feel, actually, to actually just end up being at E3 and just chilling there, being all like, hey, I'm here. Ooh. Because I could imagine it being cool, but at the same time, like, really, like, iffy. Because obviously you could watch all the conferences online or, like, on TV. I don't know if they do that this year, but remember back before you could watch it on TV, but, like, because you could, like, watch it. Like, it's really accessible to watch. So I wonder how it is to actually be there. I feel like the only cool part would be, like, if they do what they did that one year with the Xbox. I don't remember what, I think they gave the Xbox Slim, 360 Slim, out one year. But like, if they do something like that, or it's something, oh, sweet, countdown, where like it's under your seat and you get, like Oprah, like, oh, you got a free car, or something like that. I feel like that'd be awesome. Or like they did what Bethesda did, where it's like, hey, we got Blink-182. Oh. It's in a minute, but maybe this is just, yeah, this is nothing. Or there, what was the second, yeah, like Bethesda did, Blink-182 is gonna play after this, you know, stuff like that, like surprises. Obviously, if you go to E3, you can play like the games early and stuff as well. I feel like that's kind of a whole different story. I'm gonna kind of slow down my talking while I wait for the show to start anyway. Sounds like it's about to happen. Okay. I mean, there's no countdown anymore, so I guess they're finishing up the final touches. It's the only thing I could think of. All right. All right. Two. Showing off the games that they have and stuff. Obviously, there's Star Wars and stuff, Darth Maul. Alright. There's a lot of sports, though, but I mean, it is EA. Just really weird seeing all these, like, different things. Cool intro, bro. That was kind of a rough cut, but okay. This is another reason why I like you said all the debacles and all the hilarity and the cringe, because like it's actually really funny. I'm just trying to savor this moment. They have like NFL stuff. Okay. I'm gonna put the volume a bit higher. There you go. I'm watching on EA, not, you know, Twitch E3, but all right.
Devin, I covered your career at the University of Texas. Would
yeah.
you disappear to
Frost. Oh, they're doing the same thing they did with FIFA with Madden? Question mark.
Today is the day that we put
Yeah.
Mathis on the NFL map. Long shot from the depths of the unknown, being drafted by an NFL team.
All their eyes on you. This is stopping from hightailing again.
But
let me ask you something. Why are you here? Because
unless it's musical sports.
Football's my life. My father used to say, when the world knocks you down.
I guess this is kind of cool.
Wait is miles behind.
Makes sense if they break sports games into like cinematics and stuff. Kind of gets people more engaged.
Devin Wade at the line for the final play of the game. It's the biggest moment of your life.
Let's go out there and prove to the world that we belong.
Yeah, it is exactly what they did with FIFA last year. I guess maybe this year. I don't remember, but I know they did the same thing with FIFA.
Round of applause for the drumline, guys.
Weak crowd.
That's Madden like you've never seen it. And I might be biased, but I'm pretty sure that's the most innovative Madden we've done
I guess.
in well over a decade.
You're the people.
Welcome to EA Play 2017, coming to you from the Hollywood Palladium. This is our second year at EA Play. Last year we went out on a limb, tried to do something a little different with a view to changing the way you interact with products before they launch. We wanted to do something that put the games in your hands earlier, and it showed us how much further we can go. As you can see, we've built a creative space here. We're right in the middle of it.
Yep.
This is going to be where it all goes down over the next 3 days, playing, creating, and sharing with the rest of the world. We've built it this way for a very simple reason. We want more of you to be able to experience this moment. For thousands of you in Hollywood this week, we have hundreds of stations for hands-on gameplay. And for tens of millions of you out there joining online from across the world, you won't hear it just from us. You'll hear it from players, right here. They're here to see new things, to ask questions, to challenge us, to tell us what they like, and especially what they don't.
I mean, I guess it's clear that they're trying to connect with their fans.
They're going to connect with each other and create content. And of course, they're going to play as many games as they possibly can. So let's set the stage for what we'll do over the next hour and a bit.
Okay.
We're going to go deep into 8 new experiences, each with major reveals.
They always say that.
Massive innovation.
Massive innovation when it's like the same game.
2 years ago, we launched Star Wars Battlefront. And we got a lot of feedback.
It's not really, you can't. Innovation.
A lot of it positive.
No, you're just doing
constructive.
The old Battlefront games, just more cinematic.
It's a euphemism for not as positive.
Actually story and stuff.
So today we're going to bring you 30 minutes of Star Wars Battlefront 2. And what we hope you'll see is that we've addressed all of the feedback.
I don't believe you.
And gone even further. We've got a mix of everything here for you. A look at new IP, some killer new trailers, demos, and a bunch of live gameplay. This
just
is going to be
it.
A lot of fun. And it should be, right? Because we're all here for one simple reason. All of us share one fundamental belief, and that's that games are the best form of entertainment on the planet.
Actually, I remember, wasn't there like a census done that EA does more talking than showing games?
Cities and countries, they inspire us.
I should have expected this.
The fires of competition inside us. Games allow us to do extraordinary things and to be extraordinary in our own ways. Games enable us to be our most creative selves. Whether that's as game makers trying to pioneer new ways to play,
most of the time you're subjected to only a certain mechanics. Can't do anything and everything in games.
For what we do. Games put the power of play in our hands to do with it what we want and to make it our own.
That one girl in the back looks so unamused.
For the next 3 days, we're here to celebrate play with all of you. And what better place to start than with a game that has taken the world by storm?
Battlefield 1.
There's more than 20 million Battlefield 1 players out there today, and we've got a lot to share about a revolution that's coming to this great franchise. So let's jump to Battlefield right from the creative heart of EA Play.
Well, what are they doing now? Hello.
Hey, everyone.
Hi, Andrew Galata.
I'm Andrew Galata, producer for Battlefield 1 at our DICE studio right here in L.A. I'm standing inside the creator cave at EA Play, where our community is creating new content to share with players across the globe. It's unbelievably rewarding to see more than 20 million players embracing the game, crafting their own memorable moments, only possible in Battlefield 1. Let's take a look.
Hey, Noob, I got some questions to ask you.
Okay.
What is it about the Battlefield franchise that's so special and appealing to you?
The thing I find special about Battlefield is teamwork.
So they got these guys to
sometimes
do
like
an
to
animation
prepare.
Sort of
or
thing?
Heal.
I guess.
Oh, I just shot an airplane out with a game bullet.
I'm most definitely proud to be a part of the Battlefield community. I've never been a part of any other gaming community where people are just so passionate about their games.
Everyone in this community is focusing on making this game as best as it can be and expanding on the experiences that we've already had.
No way!
Was mich an Battlefield begeistert, ist die schiere Bandbreite an Dingen, die ich in diesem Spiel tun kann.
Player versus tank versus plane versus environment.
My most memorable moments is what I do.
Guys are hyping it up too much.
A 64-man army that just does massive, crazy things.
I have made so many amazing friends who have become more like family.
It's something that brought a whole
lot of people together. Oh, well, there's together. James,
we'll
I guess.
Squad up and go and tear it up.
Boom!
You got it?
Oh, I killed them all! I killed them all!
What? I'm assuming that's like an Easter egg or something.
I'll never be able to do that again in my life.
That was a little too much.
Never,
yeah.
Ever. That's it. That's as good as it gets. I should just stop playing. I should quit.
He just disabled a
incredible
truck with a grenade while jumping off a horse. Incredible. We love these only in Battlefield moments, and we want even more of them. So we're bringing more ways for you to play. First, Night Maps debut this summer.
Looks like they
in
have
Neville Knights
I
and Priest Day to Her, you'll need to deploy
maybe,
tactics as you
wrong.
Fight through the night in a
wow, that's
massive
not words.
Network of trenches. Second, I'm excited to announce a major revolution in Battlefield 1. We're bringing epic battles to the Eastern Front of World War 1. In the Name of the Tsar expands Battlefield 1 to the blistering winter in the East. This is the biggest front of World War 1. And with it, we're bringing you
six like
new maps,
vehicles, and
the
then you
Russian
see a horse,
army, including the mighty Hussar cavalry, new vehicles and weapons to expand your arsenal, and the iconic Women's Battalion of Death. Finally, we're introducing a richer gameplay experience in both progression and operations mode. By bringing deeper player progression through all new assignments, the ability to tailor your playstyle with specializations, and new multi-battle experiences woven through the fan-favorite game mode, Operations. All of this coming in September as part of In the Name of the Tsar. And for the next 3 days, the Lupkow Pass map from In the Name of the Tsar is right here at EA Play. For those of you tuning in,
okay. You'll
get a glimpse of it from these guys when they share it on their channel very soon.
I guess that's neat.
So there you have it. 8 new maps in total.
Not really too hype about it, though.
Front in World War
That's just
I,
me.
With new ways to play, there's never been a better time to be part of the Battlefield
but
community. Now enough of
all right,
me.
Whatever.
Let's give you a first look at In the Name of the Tsar. A revolution is coming.
Услышишь гром, вспомнишь обо мне. Полоска неба будет твердо алой, а сердце
that's
будет
neat shotgun.
Как тогда.
Ow. Violent there, buddy.
В огне.
Hi everyone. I have the privilege of leading our global development teams. 6,000 of the most creative people making truly amazing experiences, including Battlefield 1. Now this summer is going to be huge. So much new content, so much more to play, and so many new ways to play. And there's one more thing we'll bring to Battlefield. Later this year, we're going to give you a new competitive Battlefield experience. We've heard you. You want a smaller, tighter experience focused on team play. You want all-out war built for competition, and you want it accessible to players and to viewers. And it's coming.
Okay, are they going
to
talk about esports?
I can't wait to share more with you guys at Gamescom in August. Now, competition is at the center of EA today, and we've always thought about it a little differently. We believe in making stars of all our players. Let me tell you something really cool. Last month, I was watching an amazing competitor, Shells. He made it to the FUT Championship finals in Berlin. 6 months ago, this guy was an unknown. Now he's a worldwide star. And he'll be competing with the best at the FIFA Interactive World Cup final.
They're gonna be doing
August. Now, we want to find more stars, so we're doubling down in competition in ways only EA can. This fall, we're launching the largest FIFA championship ever, with many ways to compete. The best FUT players will compete in the FIFA Ultimate Team Champions Cups. And in our official football league competitions, you can represent your favorite
there's some more of the cringe.
It's true, you can. We'll have much more to share, including our Madden plans later this summer. As developers, your passion is what fuels us. Your stories inspire us, and
this is stuff that, like I want to say, like a select few care about. This is their first time. It's their first time.
This is my first time.
This is my first time competing.
I just thought maybe this is something I could do.
So many good players.
Beat them how? Ha ha ha. First time?
Just they want to beat me.
Came back to that.
I just don't understand how people think I'm the underdog.
That is confidence right there.
This is the highest level you can play. There is a real thin line between.
But then he loses.
How nervous are you right now?
It's going to be a really tough game.
I'm never going to lose ever in my life.
Wide open!
He's just a person you can hate.
He is an absolute beast.
These people are getting really mad. I understand you're competitive, but, like, why are you chucking the controller on the floor and cursing? It's a football and it's a football game.
This is what competitive gaming is all about.
I mean, they're both football, so let me say it once.
We're about to crown a new king.
There it is! It's Rocky that is your champion!
Were you ever in doubt in that game?
I was in doubt the whole time.
These guys are going through something.
I don't want it to be me.
Ladies and gentlemen, sitting on your
shoulder. People are gonna be that salty. I don't want to play. Oh my gosh. Oh. Oh no. Technical. Oh. Okay, no, there's a trailer. they're showing the next FIFA game. This is kind of why I'm, like, not down with sports games. Because it's always kind of the same thing, just different year. Especially now that they have, like, roster changes and stuff. Like, mid-game, it doesn't really matter. Maybe there's, like, a few new mechanics, or they change it just a tad bit, but it's essentially the same game. And now they're trying to advertise it more as like, hey, Ronaldo did all the movements and stuff. I guess, cool. So yeah, it's real, in a way. It's just the animation, so. That's kind of like the whole Smeagol thing. If you're really dumb, because I don't remember who mocapped him, but obviously it's a big name, and I feel like anybody could have done that. So it's one of those things where it's a soccer game. Anybody could do soccer movements. Maybe not as good as Ronaldo. But I mean, soccer movement. Like I don't think you're really gonna be paying much attention to that anyway while you're playing. Maybe in the story mode I could understand, but like in game, I don't think you're really looking at the, you know, animations. You're like, oh, I kicked the ball, I passed it, and stuff like that. Now I love soccer. Don't get me wrong. It's just kind of like one of those. But what is this? What is going on? Are they trying to like advertise like a sports podcast or something? Oh, excuse me. I feel like they are. What's going on? That was terrible.
Oh, I went early, Rog. I went early. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the Men in Blazers. That's Rog, the bald one. I'm Davo, way less bald in person. We are delighted to be here.
Oh, we really are. Some of you will know us as the hosts of one of the top three most popular football shows ever to be produced in the Panic Room in the crap part of Soho.
That is true. Somehow, we convinced world leaders like Will Ferrell to come talk to us about the fifth best sport in the world.
Oh, we've tricked them all, Davo.
Yep.
And the common thread for us is always football.
You just copied what he said.
I speak to players around the world. They all tell me their experience with FIFA runs so deep.
I like the charisma, though. At least they're hype about it. It's just
that is art influencing life.
It's all melding together. Rog, look at this. Look at how the world's game comes to life in FIFA 18. Player personality that differentiates even the talls from the smalls.
They've even perfected the inimitable run style of Raheem Sterling.
It's a video game. And it's an animation.
Technical ability to suavely park fly past
taking it too much.
And so suave.
And these atmospheres, Rog, take a look at this. They make it feel like you're in the Argentinian sun with your pasty white legs. And this is massive, Rog. They've now got the ideal athlete.
People just want to see
to the game.
If they
anyone
care
better
about
and more
FIFA,
genetically sound than Cristiano Ronaldo? Could you get anyone better than that?
That man doesn't have a six-pack. He's got an eight-pack.
You're right.
And EA Sports know the only way to make Cristiano.
I mean, I gotta give Cristiano Ronaldo some props though for actually like going in the mocap. He didn't have to do that.
He's done
at
it
all.
Let's hear back-to-back champion of Europe.
For him
the La Liga.
He must have got paid a lot to do that. Then.
Literally every trophy.
So I don't see why else.
Impressive from our perspective.
Unless he plays the game, he's like, oh, cool.
He has hair, Roger. You know, but as huge as Ronaldo has been this past year, there's one story bigger than them all.
Oh, yeah. Peter Moore becoming CEO at Liverpool. Good luck with that one, mate.
Yeah, no, Rog.
Yeah, he was.
No, Rog. The biggest story in football is, of course, Alex.
Are they continuing that?
The new hero.
Is that what
of
they're
the
trying to say?
Pitch and the star of The Journey.
The Journey.
Alex would go on to score more than 360 million goals in his first season. Wow. Oh,
that one's true, and so is this one. Whenever our good old English national team take the field over the past year, the single name most tweeted, even more than Sir Harry Kane.
What are they doing? Yep.
Alex Hunter.
Yeah, we could have used him today, Rog.
We could have won it all.
Yeah.
Talking about winning it all, though, what a storybook year Alex Hunter's had.
Yeah.
Winning the FA Cup, just 18 years old, barely passed his bar mitzvah.
Okay.
He's experienced more in his first season than I will in my entire life.
That is true. It was quite the start to a truly amazing journey.
But the life can't
of
take this anymore.
It's a journey filled with victory, defeat, glory and conflict, dreams come true.
End me.
Lie ahead.
So, everyone wants to know.
End my life, go. No, stop.
I don't know, Davo, but it seems like everyone's got an opinion.
You know, I like how at the beginning they have Battlefront 2. It's obviously going to be the last thing they're going to show.
Alex Hunter is being talked about.
I think that's just paper talk, if I'm honest.
Like, I'll be honest, I kind of don't really care about Battlefront 2, but if it looks a lot better than the first one, then I'd consider actually playing it.
Alex Hunter is in the media every day.
The first one had such a lack of content.
Irritating. What kind of club would let Alex Hunter
go? As you can tell, I don't care about Alex Hunter.
This guy's getting too big for his boots, blood.
Alexander is a great player.
He's a beast. Yeah, she is.
He's very quick.
He's got skills.
Amazing skills.
Hunter is an attaccante phenomenal.
Hopefully he's got good people around him.
Hunter's bombed his bridge.
He has to look after himself.
Go! Go!
I would move.
Rumours have got to stop.
Don't go, Alex.
Alex Hunter.
Game engine footage.
Will Alex Hunter stay?
You could do graphics now. Cool.
Are you sure
this is the gameplay good? That's all that matters in games now. Does it look good? But if it plays bad, then why does it matter? It plays good. And cool. Okay, look. Hey, look. They got... Wowie. Yeah.
What up, guys? Thank you
Wowie,
for having
they got
me.
Jesse.
If you guys don't know who I am, my name is Jesse Wellens, and I am a YouTube creator.
This makes more sense.
I am here to talk about Need for Speed.
Payback. Oh, he's losing it.
If you guys didn't know Need for Speed Payback, Yeah, it's a great game. But, all right.
Okay.
All set aside.
I'm at least he figured it out.
Speed Payback, it's coming out.
He seems super nervous. I don't think he's ever done it before.
He is the producer of the game.
Maybe that's why all the developer guys sound like robots, because they got to...
Hey, man. Thanks, Jesse.
You know, and he's trying to unnatural it.
Everyone about Need for Speed Payback here today, but more importantly...
Yeah, he's clearly reading a teleprompter.
...mission to take down the house. House is a cartel that rules the city's casinos, criminals, and cops, and that is delivering a brand new experience with wild heist missions, intense cop pursuits, grueling car battles, and jaw-dropping action moments. No longer is it just being about being first across the finish line. We are putting you behind the wheel of an action-driving fantasy.
So Need for Speed has been around for a long time. There's been a lot of new things coming to the game, and a lot of old things that people are familiar with the franchise.
Exactly. You know, we're putting a new narrative into the game where you drive three different characters, Tyler, Jess, and Mac, all bringing their own unique playstyle to the game. You drive across city, mountains, deserts, and canyons in the most diverse open world ever made for a Need for Speed game. There's a lot of great new elements in this game, but also, obviously, a lot of fundamentals like customization. We go way deeper when it comes to visual and performance customizations, as well as introducing something on top of that, something we call derelicts, which are abandoned classic cars that you transform from scrap
Need for Speed
to
games,
stock
like
to supercars.
Become Halo's Jack from Rooster Teeth.
Nick,
since when did Need for Speed games, like open world and all that,
Beetle.
It's kind of weird.
He's going to be doing a lot more of this customization and gameplay at 1:30 on the stream if you want to come back. But enough talking about it. I'm trying to see it.
Yeah, you know we're... Absolutely, very excited to show you the first one of the blockbusters
from
Need for Speed Payback called the Highway Heist that shows that intense action driving experience. So let's turn around and take a look.
Koenigsegg Regera, 0 to 60 in 2.7 seconds. We intercept, then grab the cargo.
It'll be part of a convoy.
What are you thinking?
Quick hit and run. Get me close to the truck and I'll take care of the rest.
So, you try... Oh, yeah. Actually, this makes a lot of sense. Because I heard that the Need for Speed movie was trying to be Fast and Furious, and it seems like now the Need for Speed games are trying to be Fast and Furious. Where you just not... Since when did Need for Speed games turn into, hey, try to knock this away and get away from the cops? That's Fast and Furious. In a nutshell, like, what happened to it just being, like, nice racing? That was awesome. I remember Need for Speed Underground? That game was great. Now look. What are they doing? It's like, they totally saw Fast and Furious and trying to cater to the people that love explosions and stuff. How is all this distraction How is all this destruction happening by, like, one truck? Makes zero sense. Why are things explode? What's going? Does he have like red barrels that he's like throwing out or something? Like I don't understand. Is this Donkey Kong? But with cars. So yeah, you could. Well, he hurt himself, I guess. So yeah, you could bang into. Okay. How come your car doesn't take much damage, but theirs just gets destroyed when you hit them? Obviously, you're moving too. Like, is there even any cosmetic stuff that, like, I just, maybe the game's in, like, alpha or something, but is there any, like, cosmetics that's happening to your car? So, obviously, the performance is the same. Yes, this is exactly being Fast and Furious. Get on the side, there's a ladder on the side. Like. And there's never people performing stuff either. I don't. Okay. It's in the back. Oh no! Oh look, you switched people. Oh wow.
I got this.
Yeah, I don't think I'd had fun with this game. It just seems too over the top. Like they're trying too hard. Kind of like the Transformers movies. Like, it looks cool, but is the story alright? That's what I just... Okay. I guess I'll trust him.
I can assure you that plays as well as
trust.
It looks.
Last and like year, EA got voted EA the worst Play, company at one point.
EA Originals. The program was something we created
innovative.
To support small
you're gonna hear that word a lot.
To help bring experiences that are unique, gorgeous, innovative, and memorable to the world. We are partnering with game creators through the process from development to marketing to publishing. But EA Originals is also about funding, about offering a level of security. The profits from these games go back to the hands of the developers. We have been overwhelmed with the indie community's reaction to this. I can
like?
Tell you, we have
explain them, tell
hundreds
me.
Of pitches, many of them brilliant.
Okay.
And as a result, we now have several new titles
what
in
is
development.
It?
Today, I want to introduce you to our next EA Originals title, one that I've been very close to from the beginning. This game tells a story in an entirely new way. Now, a few years ago, I played
okay,
the
I
indie
know EA
game Brothers.
This is my Microsoft. When's Cuphead coming out?
I loved how different the game felt. The mechanics and storytelling were really cool, and we both loved the emotional story. So I decided to contact the game's creator, Joseph Farris. When we met, we instantly realized we shared the same passion for games and how to bring new experiences to players. I also found out that he was building a new studio called Hazelight. Now, we're thrilled to be working with Joseph to bring his new project to all of you. What started out as a wild idea on paper has now turned into a groundbreaking, one-of-a-kind game called A Way Out. Take a look.
Okay. What kind of game is it, though? Well, obviously, you're...
Stay the hell away from me.
Is this kind of one of those you try to break out things? Because I guess that would make sense, but... It seems to be story-driven, that's for sure.
I'm sure you have good reasons
a
to
co-op
bust out of here,
adventure.
But I need to get out of here too.
Okay, yeah. So yeah, it's like the escapist, no but like 3D. I guess that's neat. Well, you can but thing is, would there be replayability?
It's pitch black. We need a light.
Oh, well, clearly it just kind of showed them breaking out. Now what? Oh, I guess running away. I guess that's cool. It's more than the escapist. Well, I said,
you have a problem?
Yeah, I got a problem.
How did the hospital let him in?
I love you, buddy.
That's it. What are you doing here?
Just oh, it didn't.
See? Problem solved.
See? I hate it when things do that too, because there's this movie trailer I watched recently where like the person like died in the trailer and you're like, well then why did you show that?
Hey, my name is Joseph Farris, and I'm the writer, director.
He kinda looks like one of the guys
I'm
there.
I'm so excited to be here.
Maybe that was the point.
So, after I finished Brothers, I wanted to make another game that pushed the boundaries on how to tell stories without compromising on gameplay. And this is the reason why I started Hazelight Studios together with the team behind Brothers. And working with EA's Originals was perfect for this, because we have the full creative freedom and trust
I think that'd
from
be important
EA
for
to
anyone.
Live in the game we truly believe in. And that is very important for Hazelight, let me tell you that. So, the idea for A Way Out came to me when me and a friend trying to find a co-op game that wasn't just a drop-in, drop-out experience. I wanted to play a game where the characters had unique personalities and goals. A game where me and a friend can embark on an emotional journey together. And this is exactly what A Way Out is. The game is designed for split-screen co-op only, and I mean only. So you will be able to play it online, but to get the full experience and feel, want you and your friend
I guess
to play
that's neat.
Couch. And
people together,
gameplay-wise, Yeah, couch, nice, right? Action.
Actually, finally, I guess that is really cool.
And what was?
They're going against the norm.
Okay, wait, it's coming to me. Come on. Gameplay-wise, it's going to be crazy. There's going to be a huge amount of variation. You're going to be able to play everything. I mean, not everything, but a lot of stuff. There's going to be exploration, driving, action. So you won't get tired of this game, I'm telling you. So, but let me tell you this. After you finish playing a Way Out, I will tell you, you will play a co-op game.
It's pure replayability. Like, or I guess if you play with a different person.
I mean,
or something, but it's going to be the same game.
Hockey, but I can't help it because it's true. I'm so pumped up, it's crazy. You don't know, I live, breathe this game. I'm telling you, it's like, it's going to kick ass. It's going to kick ass. So right now, I will show you a gameplay video. It's going to show you just a small part of the game, but still, you're going to get blown away. And I also want to say that I'm so proud and happy to be part of this industry. It's crazy how fun it is to be here and do these games. It's so much fun. And also, one last thing.
What?
I want to say hello to my Hazelight team watching live from Sweden.
Hop shaky boom.
Goodbye. Hop shaky boom. Come on.
A Way Out is a story-driven co-op game. It is designed, played, and experienced only in split-screen co-op.
It's going to be split-screen.
Which means you have to play the game with a friend, either online or on your couch. The game starts in a prison. You play as Vincent and Leo. You and a friend will get to know your characters and unfold their story.
I guess replayability is you play the other person.
Maybe not. But Harvey killed someone very close to me.
This is a lot different. This is.
I'm going after him.
Let me show you some of the scenarios in the game. On the right side, you see Leo, who's already in prison. On the left, you see Vincent, who just arrived. Now, if you look to the right again, you can see that Leo can be controlled while Vincent is in a cutscene. Here's another one. Vincent and Leo are now in the laundry room. Your goal is to smuggle sheets using a laundry cart. You can approach the scenario in different ways. Either get the cart with Vincent.
No, I got a good pack right here. I think it's got your name on it. It's broken.
All right, then.
Or with Leo.
Get over here, you idiot.
Yeah, but I think those two guys are just about to fight.
Well, that was obviously not you, but okay.
What the? What? Who's him?
In A Way Out, you will experience something new all the time. Everything you do in the game is unique for that scene. We want you and your friend to be focused and engaged throughout the entire story. But let me tell you, this is just the beginning of what you will be experiencing.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm feeling this. This is pretty neat. I feel like it's a niche thing, though. Like, it'd get kind of boring after a while. But I've never seen anything like this. I'm kind of a harsh critic. But it looks cool. Yeah. I'd clap. That's cool. But
I know, me again.
Don't overhype it though, just be like, yeah, that's cool.
Thank you, Joseph. That game is absolutely stunning and I can't wait for you guys to get your hands on it. Now let's switch gears for just a minute. It's great to be here showing you the games you'll play this year. But at the same time, we are inspired to look farther ahead. Creative ideas combined with new technologies become an unstoppable force. We have teams today taking technologies that are changing the world and using them.
They're about to show Battlefront 2 now.
These are the futurists, the incubators, our talented artists, designers, and engineers within our studios, our Frostbite team, our digital platform team, and a new research division called
Engines, I think.
What motivates me every day is the responsibility we have to push our industry forward. That's one reason we created this new division.
I feel like the only people that really would care about something like this are the
exploring some of our
investors.
Most visionary concepts.
This isn't really something
like deep learning or neural networks. Creating a world for you to define, to interact with, and share as you wish.
Like consumers want to hear.
Or virtual humans with deeply sophisticated artificial intelligence. So instead of one main character shared by millions, we can have millions of main characters shaped.
If you really want to blur, go to... Wow. If you really want to blur, go to ER. ER. go to VR. Don't share your discoveries. Don't go to the ER. That's bad.
Now, what we know today is that interactive entertainment will change more in the next 5 years than it has in the last 45.
So, you know, I'm out of it. I'm kind of like bored because I said ER instead of VR.
One that disrupts, empowers, and is full of play. And to do that, we also need innovative new platform technology.
So when they're talking about Microsoft
first
stuff now.
Project Scorpio dev kits from Microsoft. 6 teraflops and true 4K graphical fidelity. Now these Mad and LFS.
The only thing is, if you don't really have a 4K,
so just a taste of what can
I don't think you could really see it
with Project
perfectly,
Scorpio.
But it
and
does look
already
good.
We are creating the most detailed, high resolution environments you've ever seen on a console. Madden looks absolutely stunning, but as game makers,
that's what
awesome
I said. It
graphics
has to look good. It
beginning.
Could look good, just fine.
The game has to feel
but
amazing.
But if it plays
well,
that's all I care about.
Project Scorpio is a powerful platform, and it's
don't
coming
really
at
care
the
about
right
Madden,
time.
Though.
Now, I have one more thing before I go. New IP is one of the purest forms of innovation in our industry. A brand new idea combined with the latest tech and a vision for something extraordinary. The next game will push every boundary for you. It is vast, dangerous, beautiful, and unexpected.
I mean, because they said
so
30 minutes of Battlefront
that we're showing you today. Then we will have so much.
But now it's a new IP, though.
Microsoft press conference
so,
tomorrow.
So okay, yeah, I thought they're going to announce that BioWare.
But for now,
but wow,
here's the
that
first
BioWare,
of our brand
IP.
New IP.
Because I'm sure they give up on Mass Effect.
The wall. It's our armor. It protects us from what lies beyond.
Seems pretty promising for now.
But out there,
kind of looks like you're in a Titan, though.
You either live with the choices you make.
Okay, so exosuits and stuff.
Or die.
And them. And him. Okay, so Microsoft's briefing, you're going to see more of the game. Okay, I guess it's neat that they like do a teaser and they say, hey, just tomorrow. So I'm pretty sure Microsoft's tomorrow.
Hey,
NBA Live.
I'm Sean O'Brien.
Dude, no one plays NBA Live.
About NBA Live 18 with you. But instead of
everyone
talking
likes
about it, I'd like to show you. We've spent the last 2
everyone
years
likes 2K.
Overhauling virtually
no one plays NBA Live, dude.
Aspect of gameplay.
Chill. Why do they? I didn't even know they still made these games.
Station out in FanFest, so you can check out some of those improvements. And then we're going to come back in here and give you more details about how NBA Live 18 introduces an entirely new way to play a basketball game. We call it the One. Gibbs, Connor.
Oh, he's echoing hard.
Thank you, Sean. You look fantastic every single time I see you. We are here out at FanFest.
Oh, they fixed it.
EA Play. I want to see everyone on social. Use that hashtag EA Play. Tell me what games you're excited to see. I am telling you right now, I am excited to see a first look at NBA Live 18, and no one better in the
like
business
I said, I
than my guy right
these.
Here, creative director Connor Dugan. Connor,
he looks like the dude
first
who made Fallout.
Yeah, what's up? I mean, I'm super excited.
He makes Fallout
and Malik,
but that's
to get their hands on NBA Live. We're going to take a look at a replay we just got. Q and I were playing.
I want to see the sweat.
Okay,
dude.
Q's controlling KD. Let's take a look.
Get all these angles.
I just heard someone. Was right. That a screen?
Right. So what we're looking at here is I'm using my right stick.
Oh, no, that's just the.
I'm performing any combination of moves I want.
Okay.
So behind the back, between the legs. And now I'm trying to attack the basket. But KD or Q cuts me off with a flick of his left
his
stick,
face.
And then I try to go back.
Ooh.
The middle. But Q's late. He doesn't hit his left stick. He misses a timing window. And now I have an open lane to the hoop. So we see Zaza coming over.
Tell me he finishes strong.
He does.
So if
he
uses a certain stick, he can use a certain
right
hand or something.
Finish with the left hand, as you can see here, right over top of Zaza.
He looks unamused. These facial, these facial, these facial animations are too over exaggerated. Stuff always makes me laugh though. Reminds me of Mass Effect.
NBA Live 18. Sean, back to you.
Thanks, fellas.
But who's gonna play that? Everyone's going to be playing 2K, dude.
Thank you. We're excited for all of you to get your hands on NBA Live 18. And everyone will have an opportunity to do so through a free demo coming in August. Now, this demo will give everyone the chance to start the One and be introduced.
That's exactly what 2K is kind of doing, though, dude.
Jumpstart your own.
That's exactly what 2K is doing.
Co-op and multiplayer experiences, and carry all of your progress over to the full game.
James Harden's face. Oh, yeah, dude, they're over-exaggerated faces.
NBA Live 18 is an all-new way to pursue your legacy. Centered on you, your journey is defined by the choices you make. Welcome to the one.
You know what? I think that's how they got the idea for that FIFA thing back then. Because I saw 2K NBA doing this.
Matters just as much as the rings you earn in the league.
Because I got my career and stuff.
In the league, an authentic NBA experience where you dominate the hardwood on your way to winning championships. But the new NBA Live goes beyond the league.
Taking you it's the same game.
Where the rules and how you earn respect are different. Team up with friends to take down NBA legends at historic courts.
It's the same game.
Throughout your journey,
but I guess what else would you do with that NBA game? But jeez.
As your hype builds in both the streets and the league, from Venice to Rucker Park.
I mean, granted, I think NBA Live started first. I could be wrong, and then it was 2K. But iconic, real world everyone plays course. 2K now, especially because of like there's a bunch of reasons why. But
the Pro-Am Tour. Earn the right to go head to head with the very best and show off your signature style. From East Coast to West Coast, from the streets to the league, everything you do matters. Your legacy is defined by you.
Okay, EA. To play. Whatever you say.
World. It's time for you to be.
Like, the only thing I could say is this is probably going to be a lot more cinematic than what 2K does. Because I'm pretty sure all the stuff 2K does is like an engine, and this is. I mean, obviously it's an engine, but I mean, like, this is going to be more, like, cinematic-wise, which is different, which is cool, but, you know, just I don't know how many people are really going to care about this to make them swap from 2K to this. I mean, all the sports stuff was to be expected from EA anyway. They don't really do anything else, it seems. EA Sports, it's in the game. Obviously, they got BioWare and all that, but... at least not until I see more. Only a few games honestly catch my eye now. I probably miss a few gems.
And thanks to all of the teams here sharing games today. And a special thanks to Joseph and Hazeline.
Right?
How about that for some passion?
All right.
Now, we've got a massive finale coming up here in just a moment. 30 minutes of pure, unadulterated Star Wars. But before we get there, I wanted to pause for just a moment. Last week, we did something pretty amazing together. We held our annual
what is this?
Give campaign. Celebrating the importance of inclusion
charity stuff.
And play in our communities and in life.
I can't hate on this. This is cool.
Outstanding charities, the United Nations He for She,
what?
And anti-bullying
really,
organizations,
dude?
The Pacer Center, and Ditch the Label.
Come on, man.
No? Okay. We donated $1 million to these three great organizations in support of building a more inclusive world. And here's where play comes in. All of you. Our millions of players out there joined us in support of inclusion. You came out in play in 9 in-game challenges. And by coming together, we are showing the world
the
positive force that games can be. And
okay.
Thank you for that. We're opening ways for you to play a bunch of great games for free. Starting today for the rest of the week, Origin Access, as well as the Vault and EA Access, are free. For PlayStation 4 players,
seems to always do EA Access for free during E3 time.
We're talking FIFA, Madden, PvZ Garden Warfare 2, Star Wars Battlefront, and much more. So jump in. Bring your friends.
Here we go.
Have fun with some great games this week while you're getting ready and excited for
this
what's
is
to come.
Pretty much what I was waiting for now, anyway. So let's see.
Without further ado, we bring you
John Boy
Star Wars Battlefront
Yeah, guy. Okay. Well, obviously, they're going to say yes. Because that's what everyone wanted anyway. That's what the original Battlefront did. sure John Boyega actually likes the games too. Okay. Cool. They neat. Boop, beep, bop, dee, da da, do the titties. Hello. Can you just get this over with, please?
Hello. I'm Janina Gavankar. And I play Commander Iden Versio, leader of the Inferno Squad in Star Wars Battlefront 2.
What?
I'm also an advocate for in-depth cinema caliber story in games. That tweet from John Boyega was like the tweet heard around the world. It spoke for all of us. When can we play a Star Wars story? We don't want to just relive the movies. Wow. We've watched them a million times. What we want to do is have a new and authentic, untold story.
Nah, no hate. A story that delivers
new perspectives and enables us to play as some of our favorite Star Wars characters while also introducing new ones. And just like Rogue One tells an essential Star Wars story ahead of A New Hope, Star Wars Battlefront 2 will tell a new Star Wars story that helps
bridge the gap
between Return of the Jedi and The Force Awakens.
It's good. Okay. Don't have to tell us.
It's good. But EA didn't just stop there. We loved the previous Battlefront
That's
of 2015,
what we wanted.
But we wanted more. Star Wars Battlefront 2 is
that's what you need.
Than the previous title.
You can't just shell out a $60 game with only online. Unless you're Overwatch.
Yeah.
Well, I guess Blizzard.
Now, I'm all
better.
About that couch co-op, and they're bringing it back with the return of Skirmish. So I'm going to be cuddling up with someone playing me some Battlefront 2.
Who cares?
Multiplayer, there are more heroes, more vehicles, more
You're like bragging by that point, lady.
Some of them. More space battles and starfighter assault and deeper progression and customization as well as content from across all eras. But, as we
probably
know,
a lot like the
Star
first
Wars
one.
Is not just some checklist of great features.
It's just DICE. We feel like Battlefield.
The team at DICE in Stockholm has...
Who would have thought that
years later,
people that made... Wow, excuse me, I'm pretty sure I'm tapping the mic. The people
and
that played... That made,
Game Changers to make
Battlefield
sure
are making...
Battlefront 2
Battlefront.
Has
no, I don't
the
think
that
much people
would have
thought about that.
For. These Game Changers, they basically get, like, tapped on the shoulder because they're the best Battlefront players in the world, and then they get secretly flown out to Stockholm. As long as they provide valuable feedback, they get an early look at the game. Sounds like an awesome program, and if I didn't suck at multiplayer, maybe I'd get an invite.
All right.
That's true. So, let's hear more from them about their time at DICE.
Well, yeah.
After the release of Star Wars Battlefront 1, the community thought there should have been more. And the good
news
is
they should have known better.
Really
I feel like they're too busy working on Battlefield 1 to really think much about Battlefront. They're like, oh, it's Star Wars, people are going
to
buy it.
There's still time to change something if it's not working.
That's good.
My first impression with the game is upgraded. All three eras are going to be in the game.
Thank you.
We've got a whole bunch of new features. One of the biggest ones that a lot
Thank
of
you.
Is the class system. They split the characters.
That's how the old Battlefront was. Like, you can't call it Battlefront and then not do the Battlefront staples.
It affects your health. It affects how you are going to support your team.
There's going to be more content. You're going to have to get used to a lot of new different techniques on how to play.
The gunplay and the weapons have completely been redone compared to the first Battlefront. Now there is a lengthened skill gap in it.
It feels a lot better and go, oh, okay, this gun feels kind of more real, less floaty.
Which is your favorite hero so far?
We're introducing a system called Battle Points, which will allow you to become not only heroes, but other things
on
the battlefield.
Okay.
As you're helping your team
like
play
that.
The objective, you gain these points.
There's such a plethora of things to spend it on, vehicles, or even coming in as a hero.
And the coolest thing, I think, is a level of customization, not just from a weapon standpoint,
but
the character's own abilities.
hopefully they have a beta.
Collaborating with the game changers is always a really great working environment when you're trying to figure things out.
I mean, to know that you're giving key feedback to make it a better experience for everybody, it's like putting your footprint out there and saying, look, I'm part of this.
All right, is everyone in position?
Yeah.
Ready.
Everyone ready?
So I'm going to participate in making the trailer. It's a whole different level of fantasy.
All right, recording.
So in 3, 2...
Here's the 30 minutes we get.
And now, on behalf of the EA Game Changers and DICE, this is the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2 multiplayer gameplay.
That wasn't a very cinematic cut, like from the stage to the screen, but okay. Hey! I like these maps. See more alive. Yeah, this seems a lot more like mix of Battlefield and Battlefront into like one.
Sector is clear. Not clear, not clear.
And the fact that there should be droids and stuff, and there's classes, I like this. This is good. This is exactly what we wanted. Proud of EA. I'm proud. Nice. That's good. The Emperor! Do it!
Your next assignments, they are unusual.
Grab onto something!
I'm trying!
Nice. That was good. That looked good. I like that. Who cares? No, no one cares.
Yoda, Darth Maul, Wookiees, Kylo Ren versus.
All right. I guess okay. No, I'll give her that. That was.
This even started. My mom's here.
That's all right. She'll be real.
Me, I'm sorry. So. Okay. So we have even more exciting things for you.
I, Justine. Hopefully, she's good at this.
I, Justine. Shoutcaster Alex Goldenboy Mendez and DICE developer Paul Kesslin will showcase Assault on Theed, the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer. Yep. We've got 39 game changers ready to go, head-to-head in a 20 versus 20 match, Battle on Theed, and I'm going to take the 40th slot. We'll see. Okay, but you're not going to miss this, because like maybe you've seen some teasers, but this is the real thing, okay? All the bells and whistles.
Oh, it's John Boyega.
Before we take you there,
I knew it.
Another big Star Wars Battlefront fan has some exciting news.
Hi, guys. It's John Boyega here. Thought I wasn't going to turn up. Yes, I was. But I'm sorry I can't be there with you, because I'm doing a play in London. But I do have some great news. Obviously, you know I'm a massive fan of Star Wars Battlefront 1. And now we're going into the next chapter with Star Wars Battlefront 2, and I'm very, very excited to share this news with you. We've seen Yoda, we've seen Luke, we've seen all the other characters, but where's Finn? Finn will definitely be a part of Star Wars Battlefront 2 alongside with Captain Phasma as part of the first season of free content. And there's more. On top of that, we also get to play on the new planet Crait that you saw on the Last Jedi teaser trailer in April. So this is going to be an exciting time. I'm going to be playing. If you see Finn running around whooping some ass, it's me. So I'm getting set for you guys to play with me on Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I'm excited.
Free.
Let's play.
Okay, but did you listen? That's Finn and Phasma cool. are headed to Star Wars Battlefront 2 this holiday, and it will be free.
They're just trying to keep us...
The team at DICE heard our feedback loud and clear on the previous Battlefront.
Oh, all right. I like it when developers do that. Although, I forgot about that.
At no additional charge.
Well, then that's going to be the DLC if that just paid.
The first season, inspired by Star Wars The Last Jedi, is only the beginning of the additional content coming to this game.
What about the paid DLC stuff?
For everyone who owns Star Wars Battlefront 2. Yes.
So you have to pre-order to get the beta now?
EA announced that players who pre-order will get early access to multiplayer beta and Yoda's epic lightsaber mastery story.
Okay.
So,
what if you don't want to pre-order it?
New essential Star Wars story. Multiplayer across all.
Well, I guess for free content
era,
and stuff, it's
space battles.
I don't think years to come, but yeah. But I think you say free content. I feel like that's why they just assume people are going to pre-order it because of that, which I guess it makes sense.
Yes. Right. Yes. Yes.
Well, my problem with pre-ordering games though is the game doesn't work.
I
like what if the online is crap or something? I guess it's an offline story now.
Of this team making this amazing game.
Oh well,
I can't
whatever.
They let me do this today, and I can't wait to play the game in its entirety in November. And I get to start right now, so I'm gonna go pick up my controller, and I'm gonna throw it over to iJustine and Golden Boy and Paul to take us to Assault on Theed, the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer.
Thanks so much. Hey guys, welcome to the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront.
Oh my gosh.
Multiplayer gameplay, Assault on Theed. We're ready to show you guys the live gameplay for the first time. I'm your host, iJustine, and with me here today, we've got Golden Boy and Paul Kessler,
right,
producer from DICE. What have we got going on here today, guys?
We got a lot going on today. First of all, what we're going to see today is a three-stage mode. It's our new gameplay. We'll be showing people going. The droids are attacking Theed. They'll be going all the way up the main pathway towards the Royal Palace. They need to escort the MTT tank. From there, if we progress to stage two, the droids need to try to bypass security, make their way into the palace itself.
Oh, okay. So it's kind of like
if
a rush.
If successful, they'll be able to take on the throne room, and there the droids will ideally try to capture that from the clone army. Unfortunately, the clone army's still there, needs to try to push them out. And make that last day.
I like this because it's a lot like Battlefront. Like, it's got some strategic stuff to awesome. It.
I can't wait. Are you guys excited?
It's like the old Battlefront, it seems, too. Man. So, we'll see.
You guys got to come alive over here because we're going to see some great gameplay. We have some great, great game changers who are going to be competing here. And I use competing as a term because these guys are holding nothing back just yet.
Yeah, no, it's been super exciting, and we got a chance to play yesterday, and it's just really fun to sort of get into this environment.
You know, the way they're kind of showing it's really off, in my opinion, but oh well.
Somebody here who is actually
look, it's Moose Silk.
So let's talk more about what we're seeing here and getting into this, because there's three phases to this. So currently, we're in phase one.
That's right, and also we have some great game changers. You saw one of them pop up in just a little while. It was
they're showing NBA.
Moose Silk. We also have...
That was NBA.
...aka Dankness. He will be playing as well. We have Master G, Star Wars HQ, and some NBA Live, just cuz. Why not?
This is NBA Live, though.
Anyway, here you go. So, Star Wars Battlefront 2, folks. Now, this
I like
is
how he's in third person. It's a lot like
that. Down the street of Theed here, and
Battlefront
the
that
pressure
way.
Is on for the clones. They have to hold back the assault here, Paul.
They do, definitely. The droids are sitting there trying to escort that MTT up the main pathway. If they're successful, we go on to that phase two. But right now, what we're seeing
nice
some specialist gameplay from, I think, Battlefront updates.
Yeah, let's actually talk about the specialists. And also, you're going to see a couple different classes here. This class in particular that Massive G is using is the heavy class. Specialist, Conneer Sniper, right? But the heavy class, what do they do here?
So the heavy class is great. They got a bit more health than your average trooper. They're also able to pop that combat shield, try to push into areas. So you can see those guys as pushers or defenders in some areas. But it looks like we got one of our Vulture droids right now. Not sure who's flying this guy, but these guys are great at air-to-air, trying to take out those other ships that might be coming in, that Naboo N1 Starfighter.
Dang.
Otherwise, they're there to provide some great ground support like we're seeing here, trying to get some strafing runs in on those clones.
Oh, no!
Oh.
Come on, man.
Missed that tower.
You just did it wrong there, buddy.
So
sorry about
we,
that.
We also do have the air support, but we also have ground support as well.
That guy's getting shot up.
So another thing that those air vehicles are great at is trying to take out some of the ground vehicles that you may see. The droid army has the AAT tank, something that's really great at troop suppression. But we see here a little clip of the V-Wing doing that. Oh man, he's just mowing some droids down there.
Yeah, I like this map. It seems really neat.
See this happen quite a bit, especially in this phase, because there's a lot of open field here, right? And you can just come through for some great bombing runs, really, and eliminate as many people as you possibly can. And also, you put the presence of an air vehicle out there. Players will fear the skies, and they will, you know, look for cover in this map, where it's already difficult to find cover to begin with in this phase in particular.
Absolutely.
He's shooting the wall.
Right now that there is an AAT tank sitting around on the battlefield. He is probably taking out those clone troopers, but this droid,
dang,
this vulture droid, is really stepping it up.
What I love about
they're not really.
It's like, oh, look at this great open map, and then when you start phase two, it's like everything starts coming in and coming way closer together. And we're
absolutely
talking a little bit more about the assault class. So for somebody who has just started,
oh,
playing, never played any,
that was a collision.
Do you feel like the assault class might be something perfect for them to pick up?
I think the assault class is yes, absolutely. It's something that is that's painful.
Well, there's a tank
for
something
that a lot of players will be able to jump right into. They're your frontline flanker attacker. I think they're going to be fairly easy. You can get right in and just start having, you know, your typical run and gun action. Their signature ability, you see here at the top of their screen, their number two ability, that switches you over to a shotgun. You get a little bit faster, and you're able to really get in there and kind of, you know, break through those front lines.
Oh, I love it. I love using the shotgun, man. It is so good. And it's actually, when I first used it, it really caught me off guard. I wasn't expecting it.
Mm.
And I said, wait a minute, I could destroy people with this. So I just charged into the room and just absolutely shredded everyone. It was so fun.
It's cool how they're all in third person.
Great
dogfighting
here.
I'm sure a lot of people are kind of pissy because they're like, oh, I want to see the first-person views.
This is certainly what a lot of folks love in Star Wars, and just really in any game that DICE makes, right? They just always do a good job with the air combat.
Someone has Han Solo, I think.
Down. This vulture's
really,
that didn't look like a
trooper.
I don't know. Looked like someone was like a hero or something.
Assault class again, and you saw here that he has the signature thermal detonator that he'll be able to kind of suppress some of those guys with as he rushes in.
And there
there's
are
a tank.
Different weapons as well. Like one of the guns that
sticking out.
Oftentimes used
just taking them out.
Automatic gun. It, you know, fired a lot slower, but you can get some great.
Tank seems like it could take a lot of damage.
This nice compact SMG style, you know,
yep,
blaster that really shreds through people in close range. I was, you know, using a little.
I mean, we
want to
give you a little bit more weapon
too
variety this time around, you know.
Yeah.
Also, some AAT tank action here, and this is that doing what it does best. It's
oh, that's a dangerous move.
Clones out of the way.
Trying to make their way forward as the objective continues to march down. He has to get away from that.
He's trying to, I don't know, is he trying to flank the tank? That's not
smart.
I don't know, man. Maybe he will. Maybe
you saw a little combat roll there. Got to give you some escape options in case you get into some hairy action.
Uh-oh, we didn't get to see this one before. Finally,
oh,
tell
we
us
haven't
about
some ATRTs. Yes. So
he's taking them
these
out.
These are great for taking out those AATs. So these guys are a little quick. They have an ion charge ability.
He's jumping. He's like, oh, God, no. Oh, God, no.
Should they see it? So you can imagine like three or four of these on the battlefield really rushing out points. Like, look at this. He's just
can you stop someone
through
else? What can you
he got him
with this?
You can run someone over if you want.
I was actually going to say, could I get shot off
just
of it?
Just move
again. On top of it because my body's exposed.
I find it interesting how they're not showing like Jack and stuff.
You know,
almost immediately.
Right? Yeah, almost immediately. Oh, man. So Mr. Muselk here. You know, look for this guy to be on a team.
Oh, okay, he was the officer then.
And also, I did want to highlight, we had an officer, as a matter of fact, right in front of Star Wars.
We did,
HQ
one of my
there
favorite classes.
What is it about the officer that makes it so unique?
I mean, my Twitch skills aren't where they used to be. I'm
fair,
a bit slower nowadays, but I'm able to really buff up my class.
That was a good dog
fight. Teammates,
yeah.
Try to let them get some extra health, let them push through the points faster. And
what happened there?
Finally, some good dogfighting going in there.
Okay.
So
all right. And
what's great about some of these starfighters is these are accessed through our new battle points.
See, it seems
so
more.
Instead of finding a
I like that because it's better.
Map like we used to in the last game, you're now able to, depending on how well you do, whether you're scoring points via kills, via team play assists, or you're playing the objective like we really want players to do, you're earning points.
Although I'm sure a lot of people will be like, but what if you're bad at the game? You don't get your advantages.
And the battle points that allows you to unlock all of those things.
All those things, definitely.
And also something to look out for, too, when we get into phase two, that's when battle points are really going to play a role there, right?
I mean, right now, definitely, you see a lot more. It's an open space. You have time for this air combat and some vehicle gameplay. But once we get inside, it's going to be a different story.
Oh, wow.
Things are
I like that one.
What is this happening, right? This is a lock-on just trying to shake him out.
Yep.
Oh, what just happened?
Enjoy their air combat here, because that's not going to be happening.
Dang, Musilk got him good.
Him. Oh, he got picked off. Nice job.
But he was doing what he needed to do, support his team, right? It's that combined fire. You want to make sure that somebody's trying to cover you from the air.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
So, and you can see after every respawn as well, you get those.
How many points you're earning?
That seems fun. I just kind of wish that you didn't have to pre-order it to play the beta like in the first one where it was just an open beta.
Different types of traps as
yeah,
well.
Absolutely. So they have access to a trip mine. So if you want to sit there and you want to be, you know, that true sniper character, you set up some trip mines behind yourself, make sure nobody can flank you. But really, you're there to provide some of that cover fire downrange. And it's especially potent in this area because it is such a big open area. So that special can really shine in phase one.
Some more bombing runs here and just absolutely tearing them up. I have to say, man, Musouk is killing it in this world.
Again, just doing great. And, oh, and we see there one of the officer classes right next to one of the clones.
I could see watching this to me isn't too fun. Definitely. I could see playing it being pretty fun. Especially depending on what you're doing. So, I don't know. I'm typically not into super esports stuff, so I don't really like watching games unless it's like really good commentary.
Still able to complete that push, or on the opposite side, if you're one of the droids, you really need to lock down a point.
And rather your commentary, like, hilarious commentary than like play by plays. Because I feel like when you hear a play by play, you feel like they're trying to say, hey, you're an idiot, you don't understand what's going on. Like, I feel like I could do play by plays. Oh, look, he's shooting him. He died.
Siege mode,
like,
in siege mode, just for a limited time, you're able to just blow up just some huge area effect shots. You lock down your position, but you're able to.
Yeah, the battle droids are dope.
We also just saw the B2 super battle droid there as well. That's something you can get.
Another
in
one of my favorites.
Well.
Another one of my favorites.
What's going?
Yeah,
oh, they went through the palace, I guess.
Those guys great at push points again. Where they have high health, a lot of rapid fire. Oh,
here we go.
Oh, there it is.
And this big explosion indicates phase one is over. Now we start phase two. And this is when the action really begins to pick up here because it gets really tight inside of that building and players need to be mindful of that. And look for this B2 to just shred through everyone, especially with that cooling ability that
All
he
right.
has to be able to keep him just constantly shooting in the fight.
He's gonna make a huge difference here as the fight moves inside. I mean, there's gonna be narrow pathways. He's gonna be able to just shred as soon as anybody gets in his way.
Uh-huh. It's those oh, there's Darth Maul.
Corridors, it's gonna be trouble.
He got shot up, though.
Prime opportunity to push up here. Player's falling. Got, you know, white boy there.
Oh,
there. Oh, here we go.
This is some Darth Maul
yes.
action.
Here we go, folks.
This
Darth
is where
Maul.
It starts to get interesting.
This is
those
Darth
are some
Maul
cool abilities.
All right. He's a great mobile attacker. He's gonna
especially
sit there with
his lightsaber.
Close
quarters, too. So
oh, exactly.
He's absolutely perfect for that.
Absolutely. I mean, some of his abilities you can see here, he's got that spin attack. He's able to just rush in and out of combat and just take guys out in the process.
It was funny, I was talking to Musou earlier, and he was using Darth Maul, and he was saying how, there's Boba Fett as well, but he was talking about how he wishes Darth Maul could reflect. If he could reflect, he'd be
I was going to say something, but I don't remember. If you look at W.
Oh,
yeah.
That was a good flank by Boba Fett and Maul. Just
the health, well, I guess the health pack stuff's going to be by a certain class now, and it's not going to be dictated towards, like, a health droid on
the
map.
I'm
going to miss that.
This is where Boba Fett will really shine. With that jetpack of his, he's able to kind of float above the battlefield, fire off some rockets, and really just take out an individual target.
And so what difference does he have from the last game?
From the last game, we've given him a bit new tricks. He's got a new concussion rocket that
sounds a lot like Farah.
He also has this rocket barrage instead of just one rocket. He's able to really just lay down some suppressive fire.
Nice. Also, one thing to keep in mind, we saw the B2, here we go, but on the clone side, you know, there are specialist you know, characters that you can pick up as well. We haven't seen much of it yet, but that would be the clone jump trooper.
That's right.
Very
that's
different
right.
from the standard, like, assault class or heavy class. It has the jump jets that you love from Battlefront, the original.
That's right.
Brought back here, but now focused on the central class. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Bye-bye.
Look at that.
He's shredding.
He will just lay down so much firepower. It's intense.
Oh,
oh they got him, though.
Down. Jesse was able to find him on that one, yep. But here comes some officer gameplay here.
Oh, good. Finally, somebody played some support.
Support people matter, too.
They
you
do.
Know?
They
you
do.
Gotta give them some love.
We're the linchpin of the team, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Now, what is his 2 exactly? His 2 is the healing ability?
His 2 ability is that, yeah, exactly. It's that healing ability. It gives you a little bit of buff for your little over health, but it also heals you back up. So it's, oh, here we got some of the jump troopers.
Oh, boy. And
it looks really
it's
easy to control.
Just a little bit. There's a jump trooper. We talked about him before. Jump Trooper, super fun to play. But again, you know, it's attached to a specialist now, so not everyone's going to have...
Oh, there's Rey and Darth.
...really fun in the original Battlefront.
That's right.
But I am going to be excited to hop in a Jump Trooper and shred people myself.
I mean, Ranger I know people, we love this, people, a lot of people love the jump pad.
Oh,
geez.
Now we've got Rey! Oh. Not going to lie, I'm super excited to play as her.
She's quite a powerful character.
Don't run.
Some of her abilities.
You know, she got out of that one really,
don't
really
run.
Quickly. But oh, they got her.
The droid.
Oh, bye-bye, Darth Maul.
Finished her droid.
No, but Rey
so
has,
how does her
Rey has
mind trick affect enemies?
Absolutely. So Rey's mind trick is something that against
look,
Jack. All enemies, they'll be confused for a little bit. Your controls will kind of, you know, work against you, making you a little bit more vulnerable to attack.
Just so you guys know, this is when it gets insane. Because they
Noah J456 is there, I guess.
Was that a little Han?
We saw a little Han, yeah.
Are we gonna get some Han?
I hope so.
And all these YouTuber names. I like how they're just not, like, mentioning that they're there, and it's kind of like, oh yeah, we got these guys. Like, I feel like if they would have, like, said these big names, more people would have probably tuned in. Although, I guess they're not really talking about it. They're just playing the game.
Trying to be mobile, trying to fly into that last zone and capture a point.
Really, I wonder if Snoop... No. They're not doing the Snoop Dogg thing. I wonder if they are going to let him in again. Oh, it's White Boy 7th Street.
Absolutely dominating the clones. They need to push out. They need to fight this one out here. There are so many lives left that the Separatists have to their team.
We're only naming names that I know.
The clones have to start acting fast because if they cap it, that will be it. The Separatists will win this game.
It's not looking so good for my boys in the clone army.
I'm a Separatist fan. So I'm excited.
I'm just going to go on whichever team.
I don't really mind who wins.
I'm not going to be too picky here.
Okay, you jump and ship. I understand that. You know, no loyalties. Maybe you are Sith after all.
Ooh. Maybe I am.
Oh, who knows?
Shots fired.
Shots fired.
Yeah, so in this third phase, though, in the droids are trying to capture that throne room. So you can see here, if you remember, it's just...
You know, the commentator's pretty echoey as well,
super
I guess.
Close quarters. Do you have any, like, sort of strategy?
Nobody's really paying attention about it.
Absolutely. I mean, if you're the clones, you're hoping that... Oh, jeez.
Han Solo was just getting torn up.
This is going to be trouble.
It's like too soon, man. I can't relive Force Awakens again, you know? Like,
defeat.
Darth Maul is just destroying absolutely everything. I mean, is there any tips to, like, taking him down?
I mean, you want to have a... Try to combine...
Ooh, Silk. Yeah.
The tip is... Blasters.
Run away. Maybe run away.
Run away and just shoot the crap out of Darth Maul. Oh, man.
He was our MVP. Look at that.
Nice stuff.
Is that 30 minutes?
36 kills he ended up picking up there,
man.
My
goodness.
It was okay.
Yeah, that was it. What did you guys think?
Intense.
Not bad.
That's what I was saying. It looks cool, but...
I love it. It's so good. It's like, I love the class-based gameplay, personally.
Why'd they just show that? Because, again, that's a random thing to show.
Get your squad, your friends, to get together and say, like, hey, I want to, you know, run the officer, and we're, you know, we're going to do some highlights here. Maybe not with it.
Not the best highlight,
you know?
Yeah, right.
Although, maybe it wasn't.
Let's take a look at some of these
highlights. Oh! Actually, I think this is a crash montage. I think that's what we're going to do at this point. It's just all crashing all the time.
Why are all these, like, highlight people dying? And not, like, cool things that are happening? Was everyone just playing okay and not super good?
All your points, keep earning them, keep earning them, keep building, getting more and more things.
Yeah, that's right. And, again, you know, just the game. One thing I do want to compliment the team on, you know, EA and DICE,
what was that highlight? He was shooting the wall.
Seeing this part of the Star Wars universe brought to life, the way that you guys really managed to do so. I mean, kudos on that one.
Once that guy's gotta die. We'll have to just head out.
We try. I mean, the team back home is amazing. They do incredible things. I mean, you can see it looks so pretty. Look, just look at this laser.
I don't know. It's cool. It's pre-alpha, so I can't say much. Watching it doesn't seem super hardcore, but I feel like playing it would be the greatest thing
that
ever.
That was awesome. And overall, I mean, you know, I have to say, like, I can't wait to get my hands on it. I can't wait to coordinate with my friends, you know, and destroy the clone scum. I can't
that
wait
hurts.
For that.
That
yeah,
hurts.
You know, exactly. Separatists all day.
Well, guys, that was so awesome. Now, if you guys are in LA, you can come join us at FanFest this
weekend.
Boy. And if you come down on Monday, we've got a chance for you guys to win a trip to Gamescom in Germany this August. All you have to do is come and play, which is, I mean, that's not asking too much. And you have to be the best player of your match.
That's going to bring some, like, hardcore competitive people in, I guess.
To Gamescom. You've been before.
Yeah, I've been there plenty of times. It's one of the most ridiculous conventions ever, if you happen to go. It's insane. It's massive. So So you're not, you're, if you don't get the trip, you're going to be really sad. But if you get the trip, you and a buddy, oh, you're going to have a good time. It's a fun time. Hopefully I'll see you there.
Isn't that just like
you
a card game thing?
Like we do, and you guys want to play as your favorite heroes and villains, you guys can download Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes right now on Android or iOS. And you can play as any of the iconic characters that you guys saw today and many more. Paul, I also heard that you're making Battlefront 2 because you've been playing a lot of, Galaxy of Heroes.
I play a ton of Galaxy of Heroes. I've played that game every day since it launched. I think I've actually spent about $1,000 on that game.
You have a problem.
I do have a problem.
Yeah.
Oh,
but it's just, there's just so much Star Warsy goodness. I can't I can't help it.
They're just having a conversation. This isn't like even like commentary or...
Yeah, I was actually playing. I started playing in December, so around the holidays, that's pretty much all I did. It was great.
At Christmas, just...
Sorry,
the end of the.
Well, thank you guys so much for joining us here. Stay tuned to Battlefront.
Okay. I guess he's gonna. Hey guys, that's the end of this. It was super innovative. I hope you liked it. Bye bye.
Thank you, everyone, and thank you to the real rock stars of this show, the development teams inside EA. You are truly amazing. Now, we can't wait
for your biggest game. All right.
And there's more coming. Stay tuned online for a closer look at some of our biggest games.
So, you're going
to
show stuff now?
Play
afterward?
All of you, our players.
Bye-bye.
Thank you all for joining us.
Bye-bye. No sound. No. This is. So, I guess it's an RPG. The fool spent $1,000 on an RPG. So, I guess, okay. I like how there's just, like, no sound to this. Like, they completely, like, jiffed it. They didn't make... Oh, hey, look, now there's sound. See, this is why you tune into E3. Them goofing and gaffing.
Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes. Download for free today.
Well,
we're here in Hollywood, California.
I think this is the end of the conference anyway.
We're here to talk to you today about Star Wars.
Don't really want to see all this.
And a brand new character we have come to the game we teased last week, Grand
just
Admiral
talking.
Thrawn.
All right, well, I'm just going to end this here. If I missed anything, I'm sorry. But I just feel like that's this is a good stopping point. So, yeah.
It's true, I'm not actually a Jedi.
Goodbye.
But not pleasantly, it's not pleasantries. I want to get into it. I'm excited with just the Empire rework and the Dark Side Rising. We're bringing